On this Independence Day weekend, we celebrate all the freedoms we have. Welcome, friends. This is Pastor Caleb McGregor from Port Edwards United Methodist Church. Our journey as a nation toward a more perfect union has been a very bumpy ride. So even as we shoot off fireworks and grill out, we also lift up our prayers for the broken and divided nation we occupy in this particular chapter of American history. We have come a long way toward fulfilling the dreams of Jefferson, Lincoln, Sojourner Truth, and Dr. King. But we have miles and miles to go before we reach the high ideals of liberty and justice for all. As we celebrate our own freedoms this year, we also pray for those who are not free from food and financial insecurities. Let us pray for those without adequate health care or opportunities for education and training for meaningful jobs. We pray for those in our nation and others who are not free from the fear of violence in their cities and schools. Let us be reminded again that God's reign of justice and peace does not come with swords clashing loud, nor rolls of stirring drums, but with deeds of love and mercy. We know that true freedom will not come until we all dwell again in heavenly peace. But until that day comes, may we be empowered with the courage to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with our God as we offer the freedom of God's grace to all we meet. Let us read this together. How very good and pleasant is it when kindred live together in unity. It is like the precious oil on the head, running down upon the beard of Aaron the priest, running down over the collar of his robes. It is like a gentle rain from Mount Horem, which falls on the mountains of Zion. It is there that the Lord has promised blessings of eternal life. And that is Mount Hermon. On this Independence weekend, we long for our neighborhoods and our nations to experience the freedom of this psalm, the freedom of true unity. We long for the dividing walls to come crashing down. We long for an end to destructive division. In this psalm, the goodness of God-breathed unity is compared to the anointing of Aaron as high priest and the dew on Mount Hermon and Zion in Israel. True unity is precious, like sacred costly oil or a trusted source of water in the wilderness. True unity brings abundant blessing to an entire community. It is generous. It is lavish. There is so much oil, it runs down Aaron's beard and onto his robes. There is so much dew, it can cause and sustain plants, animals, and people on a rugged mountainside to thrive. True unity means goodness for all. It is pervasive, crossing unjust boundaries. The anointing oil is mixed with spices, so the aroma pervades the gathering. The new makes for fragrant flowers, fruit, and crops, which are enjoyed by the whole community. True unity is holy and unique. And the oil is set apart for the ritual anointing of a priest or king. But it is used for no other purpose. Mount Hermon is set apart for its height and snow, the highest point in the region at over 9,000 feet. Mount Zion in Jerusalem is set apart for the worship of God. True unity sets a group of people apart, a rare and beautiful light in our world. Let us pray. Pray with me these words. Holy God, one yet three, reach into the abundance of your companionship to bring forth unity and healing in our land. Pour out the oil of peace on violent homes and hearts. Shower compassion on selfish and short-sighted motives. Rain down justice, generosity, and goodness, so all are covered in blessing and harmony and life forevermore. Forevermore. Amen.
My country 'tis of thee.
Our first scripture reading is from 2 Chronicles, chapter 7. When King Solomon finished praying, fire came down from the sky and burnt up the burnt offering and sacrifices. The glory of the Lord filled the temple. The priests could not enter the Lord's temple because the glory of the Lord filled it. When all the Israelites saw the fire come down from heaven and the glory of the Lord on the temple, they bowed down on the pavement with their faces low to the ground. They worshipped and thanked the Lord, singing, "The Lord is good, whose faithful love will last forever." So there at the temple, King Solomon and all the people of Israel celebrated the festival. People came from as far away as Hamath's Pass in the north and the border of Egypt in the south. This huge crowd of people enjoyed themselves for 7 days. On the eighth day, they had a holy meeting because they had celebrated for 7 days. They made the altar holy, and it was to be used only for worshiping the Lord. They celebrated the festival for 7 days. On the 23rd day of the 7th month, Solomon told the people to go home. All the people thanked the king, said goodbye, and went home. They were happy because of all the good things that the Lord had done for David, his servant, and for his people Israel. So Solomon finished building the Lord's temple in the king's palace. Solomon did everything that he had planned to do in building a house for the Lord and for himself. Then the Lord appeared to Solomon at night and said to him, "Solomon, I've heard your prayers, and I've chosen this place for myself to be a house for sacrifices. When I close the sky so that there is no rain, or command the locusts to destroy the land, or send sicknesses to my people, and if my people who are called by my name become humble and pray, and look for me, and turn away from their evil ways, then I will hear them from heaven. I will forgive their sin and heal their land. Now my eyes are open, and my ears will pay attention to the prayers prayed in this place. I have chosen this temple, and I have made it a holy place, so I will be honored there forever. I will watch over it and think of it always. You must serve me with a pure and honest heart, just as your father David did. You must obey my laws and do everything that I commanded you." Our second reading is from Galatians chapter 5. We have freedom now because Christ made us free. So stand strong in that freedom. Don't go back into slavery again. If you try to be right with God through the law of the Old Testament, your life with Christ is finished. You have left God's grace. I say this because our hope of being right with God comes through faith, and the Spirit helps us feel sure as we wait for that hope. When someone belongs to Christ Jesus, it is not important if they are circumcised or not, marked as Jewish. The important thing is faith, the kind of faith that works through love. My brothers and sisters, God chose you to be free, but don't use your freedom as an excuse to do what pleases your sinful selves. Instead, serve each other with love. The whole law is made complete in this one command: love your neighbor the same as you love yourself. If you continue hurting each other and tearing each other apart, be careful, or you will completely destroy each other. So I tell you, live the way the Spirit leads you. Then you will not do the evil things your sinful self wants. But if you let the Spirit lead you, you are not under law. And now our third scripture reading, John chapter 8, 31 through 36. So Jesus said to the Jews who believed in him, "If you continue to accept and obey my teaching, you are really my followers. You will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. They answered, We are Abraham's descendants, and we have never been slaves. So why do you say that we will be free? Jesus said, The truth is, everyone who sins is a slave to sin. A slave does not stay with the family forever, but an offspring belongs to the family forever. So if the Son makes you free, you are really free. I invite you to pray with me these prayers. Everything that you say will be in yellow. And when we get to the petitions, I'll leave a space for each one, a couple of seconds, for you to add your own prayers within each sort of category or petition. And then when I say, Lord, in your love, you may respond, hear our prayers. Everlasting God of righteousness and grace, as our nation celebrates this Independence Day, remind us of our complete dependence upon you. We look to you for your wisdom and mercy as important issues are discussed. On this day, we ask you to keep this nation and all nations under your care, that we may be peoples who are at peace and who are a blessing to others in this earth. Grant our nation's leaders wisdom, that there would be times of peace and justice in our land and in our world. On this day, we lift up to you all who are serving in our armed forces, who serve just as the centurion did, as ones who are under authority, brave people who risk their lives for their country. Remind us of those who are far away from home and loved ones, who on this day sail or fly or walk in harm's way, and keep them always close to you. Where there is combat, grant them compassion for their enemies, and keep them brave in the face of evil. Hold in your loving hands the families of those who are far away. Grant them comfort in their anxieties, and comfort those who grieve, because they have received the dreaded message that their loved one has died. Strengthen those who carry the wounds of war, visible and invisible, and to be to them a sheer presence. On this day, keep all of us grounded, not in our strength, but in yours, ever relying upon the promise that those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. We pray for our nation's executive leaders, for President Joe Biden, for Vice President Kamala Harris, and for the presidential cabinet. Their names are listed before you. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's Congress, for the members of the U.S. Senate, for the members of the U.S. House of Representatives. So many, their names cannot fit on here. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's Supreme Court, for all the honorable judges, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For those currently leading and serving in our U.S. military, both here and abroad, please call out any names of those near and dear to you now. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's veterans, for those with PTSD and other post-war mental conditions, for those with physical disabilities, for those who are homeless, for those without incomes and health coverage, for those without family and caregivers. Please name any of those who are near and dear to your heart. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our Wisconsin state leaders, for Governor Tony Evers, for our Wisconsin Senate, our majority, our leaders and the members, for our Wisconsin Assembly representatives, the leaders and the members, for our Wisconsin Supreme Court, the honorable judges listed here. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our county leaders and for our village leaders, and that can be for whatever village or city or county that you're from. Lord, in your love, hear our prayers. For our nation's public schools and all institutions of education, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's justice system and our prisons, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's peace officers, law enforcement, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's hospitals and clinics, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's nonprofits and charities, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's infrastructure, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's homeless population, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our nation's first people, the Indigenous Americans, on whose land we now live, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's racial and ethnic minorities, for the eradication of violence against them, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For those in our nation living under the poverty line, Lord, in your justice, hear our prayer. For those in our nation without their full rights and living with injustice and in oppression, Lord, in your justice, hear our prayer. For those who work for peace and justice, resisting oppression in all its forms, Lord, in your justice, hear our prayer. For our nation's enemies here and around the world, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our spiritual and religious leaders and all working to show the sacredness of our land, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our place in the family of nations, Lord, in your care, hear our prayer. For our nation's children, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our nation's elderly, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For unity of values in our nation, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. For our laws to protect and uphold human dignity, Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. for our nation to live by freedom and liberty for the sake of happiness and blessedness. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer for our nation's future. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. God of our forebearers, thank you for this land we call home, and for those whose vision and wisdom made freedom a cherished blessing for our time. But we confess that we take our citizenship for granted. We often stake our claim to its countless privileges but resist its responsibilities. We like to remember the sacrifices of those who began the American Revolution and fought in wars both long ago and in more recent years, but we fail to see the urgent need for new dedication in our own lives to the continuing revolution in our midst. Help us to see our nation as an unfinished creation that needs our love and devotion as well as our intelligence and hard work. Deliver us from words or deeds that turn the ideal of liberty and justice for all into the vulgarity of liberty and justice for some. May the hope for our community and our nation be that we become the kind of society where every person knows you and has the opportunity to be all that they can possibly be. Enable us to see that this kind of hope will never become a reality until we become siblings by conscious effort and mature patience. Transform our Independence Day festivities into a celebration of the common life we have been given. Make our brightest fireworks be those of indignation and holy wrath at blindness and bigotry toward any person or community of persons. Translate the patriotism we espouse into deeds of constructive citizenship. Make the flag we fly a banner of joy to be a part of a nation that could be this weary world's best sign of hope. May the possibility of peace and the gift of life give us the courage we need to live like Christians in America. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who loved his holy land, but never more than his holy people. Amen. A good soldier of Jesus Christ shares in the suffering of others. This battle hymn of the Republic is a very special one in our history, but many people forget that it is an abolitionist's hymn. And what it is singing is sort of a song from the North, a song from the Union, and the truth that is marching on is the values against slavery. This is an anti-slavery song, and so I find that we lose this when we sing it, but I like to remind everyone and to think in their minds what it was like when people felt empowered, that they were on the right side of history and of justice, fighting to eradicate slavery from this land, and these images of God and the wrath. It's not just enemies. It is the wrath against things like slavery. Well, many would say there is no slavery in the United States, but I'd have us all to reflect on how are there modern forms of slavery. In fact, human trafficking is a modern form of slavery. So there is different forms of slavery that exist today, and we call these systemic racism and systemic injustices and impressions that still continue today that are very much like slavery in our history. So I want us to think about these words as we talk about the grapes of wrath and the swift lightning of God's sword and the empowerment that the people had, that God is not going to stand up to injustice and oppression forever. Thank you. vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires, hundred circling camps. They have builded him an altar in the evening dews and damps. I can read his righteous sentence by the dim and flaring lamps. His day is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. He has sounded forth the trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of all before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. In the beauty of the lilies, Christ was born across the sea with a glory in his bosom that transfigures you and me. As he died to make us holy, let us live to make all free, while God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. He is coming like the glory of the morning on the wave. He is wisdom to the mighty, his honor to the brave. For the world has been his canvas, and the path of peace he paves. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on.
Let us have a final prayer. Sovereign Yahweh, omnipotent,
God of all nations and ages, we recall the day when our country claimed its place among the family of nations. For what has been achieved, we give you thanks. For the work that still remains, we ask for your help. And as you have called us from many peoples to be one nation, grant that, under your providence, our country may share your blessings with all the peoples of the earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. Friends, go forth this week and strive outwardly for true freedom. Freedom from extreme temperatures, droughts, and storms caused by climate change. Freedom to be better stewards of God's creation. Freedom from systemic racism and profiling. Freedom from discrimination against our LGBTQ+ siblings. Freedom to make choices about our bodies. Freedom to enter this land without being illegal. Freedom to offer hospitality to all God's children. Freedom from addiction in all its forms. Freedom to offer support to any struggling with disease and chronic pain. Freedom from depression and hopelessness. Freedom to be open and vulnerable enough to share our own struggles with those who need a friend. They can trust to hear their story without fear of judgment. So go forth in the name of our Creator, our Redeemer, and our Sustainer. Amen.